our service with the greeting, "The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all."
Amen.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna to the Son of David.
Welcome to worship this morning as we celebrate Palm Sunday, which this Sunday will be turned into Passion Sunday. One of the options for Palm Sunday is to focus on the Palm Sunday procession only, but this year we're going to focus on the entire event that took place during Holy Week, from Palm Sunday as Jesus entered Jerusalem and what happened on the subsequent days, ending with his arrest and trial and crucifixion. And to help us do that this morning, the Sunday school children are putting on an Easter pageant, which will take place in the middle of the service, and they will be telling us the gospel of Holy Week, and they will include the resurrection of Jesus. It's really an Easter pageant rather than a Palm Sunday pageant. The next opportunities for worship this week here at St. Michael will be Good Friday. We'll worship at 7 p.m. And the day before that is Maundy Thursday, and the opportunity for worship there is in Lockport at Trinity, and that communion service will be at 6:30 p.m. Thursday, Good Friday here at 7 p.m. A couple of announcements about fundraisers. The meatloaf sale here yesterday got off to a great start but didn't sell out, so there are portions of meatloaf dinners and pies available today for your donation, and I think it's all self-serve out in the hallway. Please help the outreach group as they complete that fundraising. In our prayers this morning, we have prayers for the family and friends of Walt Fuller. Walt was Larry's older brother. Walt passed away this week, and we pray for his family and friends as they mourn his loss. We also are praying for Norma Huth. Norma had surgery earlier this week, and she is scheduled to come home from the hospital today. So at this point, I'm going to put on my mask as I come out into the congregation, and we will begin from the rear of the church, following the order of worship for Palm Sunday. Congregation, please stand. comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
Beloved in the Lord, let us draw near with a true heart and confess our sins unto God our Father, beseeching him in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ to grant us forgiveness. Our help is in the name of the Lord,
who made heaven and earth.
I said I will confess my transgressions unto the Lord,
and you forgave the iniquity of my sin.
O Almighty God, merciful Father,
I, a poor miserable sinner, confess unto you all my sins and iniquities with which I have ever offended you, and justly deserve your temporal and eternal punishment. But I am heartily sorry for them, and sincerely repent of them. And I pray you of your boundless mercy, and for the sake of the holy, innocent, bitter sufferings and death of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, be gracious and merciful to me, a poor sinful being.
Upon this, your confession, I, by virtue of my office as a called and ordained servant of the Word, announce the grace of God unto all of you, and in the stead, and by the command of my Lord Jesus Christ, I forgive you all of your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Taking the form of a servant, being born in the likeness of men, being found in human form, he humbled himself by becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Therefore, God has highly exalted him and bestowed on him the name that is above every name, so that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow, in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
You may remain seated as we speak the Palm Sunday verse. He humbled himself by becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. We bless you from the house of the Lord.
And now it's time for the children to tell us the story of Holy Week and the resurrection of Jesus. They are going to be speaking and singing for us. There are two places where we are participating with them, and we're actually going to reach and touch those hymnals in front of us in the pews this morning. Hymn 456 and hymn 477, they will ask us to sing. So, children, when you are ready.
Enjoy the show. But he died like a criminal. What had gone wrong? Was it all a hoax? This man who died on the cross was gone forever, and many of hopes of his followers died with him. We invite the congregation to sing, to join us in singing, "Were You There When They Crucified My Lord?" Verses 1, 2.
That is in 4:56.
When Christ was alive, we were all members of his army, and we were so proud to be serving the Lord. Why? This was our favorite song, and we used to sing it with pride.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
nothing to strive for tomorrow. We will all go our separate ways, but we will never forget how proud we were to serve in the Lord Army. Jesus will save himself and show the world his power, realize what a horrible mistake he had made. For 30 pieces of silver, he had betrayed the Lord and was responsible for his death. Judas could not bear the guilt of what he had done and hanged himself. People shuddered as they remembered the sign that had been placed over Jesus' head as he hung on the cross. As if to mock him and all he stood for, the sign said, "This is Jesus, the King of the Jews."
In all of the confusion and disappointment, people did not know what to think, what to believe, or what even to pray for. All was lost. They felt as if they had been robbed, not only of the truths they treasured, but everything they had meaning to them. A shadow hung over the earth and over the heart of the hearts who had known Jesus.
So frightened that they could not move and stood like a dead man. The angel smiled at the woman and said, "Don't be afraid. I know you are looking for Jesus who was crucified, but he is not here. He has been risen, just like he said. Jesus has risen from the dead." Then he told the woman to go find it. The disciples and tell them that Jesus has risen.
With their hearts bounding with joy, they ran to find the disciples and tell them what had happened. Suddenly, a figure appeared before them and said, "Peace be with you." The woman to Cali, and I will meet them there. The women were found, knowing in their hearts that the news he carried would change the world forever. Christ has risen from the dead. Everything Jesus said was true, and no armies, kings, or leaders could change what had happened. Christ has risen from the dead. Heaven, eternal life, and the many mansions he talked about were true. Christ the Lord has risen, and his message of peace, love, and joy would live forever.
Please join us in singing hymn 477, Alleluia, Alleluia, Hearts to Heaven, first verse.
Grace, mercy, and peace to you from God our Father and our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We have now begun Holy Week by observing the celebration of Jesus' triumphal entry into Jerusalem. And we have, as we traditionally do, waved palm branches. We have sung Hosanna, as if we were there on that day in the crowd and ushering in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ into his palace. It's easy to get caught up in the excitement of all of it. In Matthew, Mark, and in Luke, the evangelists record the event for us as it unfolds. And so we get a history of the day. There is the direction of Jesus to bring him that colt. There is the response of the disciples. There is the record of all the prophecy that this fulfilled. There is the actions of the crowd of people and the response of the rulers in Jerusalem. But in John's Gospel, which we heard read this morning, only there do we find in this account a balance. There is a moment of later recollection. John's telling of the story brings us back to some perspective on this whole week. After the prophecy is reported, John writes from his vantage point of writing 50 years after the events of that week. He wrote, his disciples did not understand these things at first. But when Jesus was glorified, then they remembered that these things had been written about him and had been done to him. John does not ask us to step into the moment and to experience it. No, John actually asks us to step out of the moment and to reflect on it. Why is that? Because John knows that after the crucifixion, after the resurrection of Jesus, things look completely different. After we have seen Jesus bear the burden of our punishment, after we have watched Jesus offer his life for our salvation, after we have witnessed his resurrection from the dead, and after we see that he now rules over everything, after all of that, this one moment in his ministry takes on a deeper meaning. After the resurrection, then they remembered that Zechariah had written, as we heard this morning, that God would come into his kingdom not riding on a grand horse in military honor, but riding on a colt in divine humility. And as they reflected on that moment, they began to glimpse the wonder of Jesus, a wonder that he had then, but also a wonder that he retains even now. As Jesus goes about his work in this world, he does everything through a way of humility. Today we remember that reality. When Jesus approached his greatest work, he did it without fanfare. In our reading, John's gospel brought us to the edge of the passion, to the hour of glory, and yet, on Palm Sunday, it is strangely anticlimactic. Jesus could really have been taking part in a royal procession, but instead, he came to sinners unarmed. He's welcomed by a sea of humanity, united in a passion that they seek for glory, only to be abandoned by that crowd and to experience the passion of God's wrath against sin all alone. Only in the recollection did the disciples realize exactly what was happening as that week unfolded. John invites us to join the disciples in their humble reflection. So today you may hear the word spoken by readers who stumble. Today you may hear that word preached by a preacher who mumbles. Today you may find our congregation to be just a shadow of its former self in the days of glory. But the message is always, take heart and rejoice and sing your hosannas, give thanks and praise, because God comes to us in humility. Jesus comes today to bring you salvation, but he chooses to come in the most humble of ways. In John's gospel, Jesus approaches his greatest work without fanfare. And in our lives, God comes in ways which are humble and quiet. When Jesus entered that city, the people flocked to him in hopes of being part of the big things that they believed he was about to do. But as with all gathering of humans, as with all movements for cause, there were malcontents. Judas, from his own inner circle, had become disillusioned, or maybe he was just tired of it all. The Monday, the Tuesday, the Wednesday of Holy Week were eventful days. There was that contentious visit that Jesus paid to the temple on Monday, the cleansing of its merchants and money changers. There were several challenges to his authority, proving that not everyone recognized God in the flesh standing among them. Deals were made behind his back, that if he were eager for glory at that time, he could easily have dashed to pieces with his power. And Jesus knew that when he was anointed by the woman with the expensive ointment, he knew that that was an ointment to prepare him for burial later in the week. At his last Passover meal with his disciples, it took a decidedly different tone when Jesus inserted himself into the rituals of eating bread and drinking wine. This was his blood that would send the angel of death away from the homes of the faithful, and this was his body that would be eaten before his people journeyed to the eternal promised land. disciples on the eve of his betrayal were too sleepy to appreciate the agony Jesus suffered on his journey. Stopping in the garden to pray along the way, they were only shaken from their slumber by the sudden betrayal by one of their own number. And then Jesus faithfully submitted to all of the indignities of the rebellious flock, turning against their loving shepherd. It was all happening, just too fast to be comprehended in the moment. Only with later reflection could the apostles write about it with understanding. The few words that the Lord spoke in his defense were sparse. This must have confounded his disciples, who had heard him speak voluminously in sermon after sermon, parable after parable, and the strained words that he uttered from the cross. So few, but so important in their meaning, made far more sense when their significance had finally been appreciated. Jesus was not just speaking prophecy, he was fulfilling it before their very eyes. But they just didn't know it at the time. In shock, they struggled to process what their senses were experiencing. And so today, we have a great advantage. We have the advantage of time to reflect on this week in the context of exactly what is going to follow. The resurrection of Jesus, the commissioning of his disciples, his ascension into heaven, and his gift of the Holy Spirit. And so today on Palm Sunday, though we like to recreate the you were there experience, we don't really need to do that, because God is already here. He's here in words that are spoken and bread that is broken. Today, John encourages us to join the disciples not in the mesmerizing commotion of the entry into Jerusalem, but in the clearer contemplation of everything that is to follow. John encourages us to remember how God comes to us. Indeed, God is here among us in the humblest of ways. By the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Congregation, please stand as we sing hymn 441, Ride On, Ride On in Majesty.
Saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and
and the life everlasting. Amen.
Let us pray for the whole Church of God in Christ Jesus and for all people according to their needs. We praise you, Father, that you have sent your Son, not in wrath, but in mercy, as we enter this most holy week and ponder together the mysteries of your great salvation. Show to us the answer to your people's prayers of Hosanna, save us now, in the passion, the death, and the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, in your mercy, uphold this world, preserve your church and the preaching of your word against all enemies. Bless our homes, that parents and children may faithfully serve one another and grow in faith until life's end. Give health and wisdom to all who serve in public office, that their authority may be exercised for the benefit of our people. Lord, in your mercy, we bring before you the sick, the distressed, and the needy, and we pray especially for the family and friends who are mourning the loss of Walt Fuller. We pray for the needs of Norma Huth, Lynn Ambrose, Dick Brown, Amy Bullard, Kevin Bruning, Jen Bush, Joanne Clark, Connie Davis, Linda Elliott, Larry Fuller, Denise Jambroni, Dorothy Haas, Dick Huth, Matthew Jackson, Don Beats, Emma, Todd Payne, Darwin Poles, Dick Radons, Norma Raywall, Tom Roll, Nancy Smith, Stasia Stanley, and Joanne Wagner. Give your abiding comfort in every circumstance, that in Christ we shall not die but live and declare his works. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lord God, Heavenly Father, we remember the sufferings and death of your dear Son, Jesus Christ, for our salvation. Praising his victorious resurrection from the dead, we draw strength from his ascension before you, where he stands for us as our own high priest. Gather us together, we pray, from the ends of the earth, to celebrate with all the faithful the marriage feast of the Lamb and his kingdom which has no end. Graciously receive our prayers, deliver and preserve us, for to you alone we give all glory, honor, and worship, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Amen.
Almighty God, grant that in the midst of our failures and weaknesses, we may be restored through the passion and intercession of your only begotten Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Lift High the Cross.